We did the best level 1 guns the other day, so I only saw fit to do the worst as well. The starting weapon in a game is never supposed to be overpowered, but sometimes the developers, they go way too far in the opposite direction. Welcome to Chaos Gaming. Today we're going to be going over some of the absolute worst starting guns in gaming history. Follow the page, turn on those notifications, share this with somebody that thinks a gun is good, but it's actually not, and let's start off with the Varmint Rifle in Fallout New Vegas. I think it's appropriate. New Vegas, well, it drops you into the pool pretty quickly. You're given a quick explanation of the world, you make your character, and you're set on your way. Now, one of the first things you probably want to do in this situation is find a gun to defend yourself. And while there are a handful of guns available to you at the start of the game, the Varmint Rifle is easily the worst. It's a bolt-action rifle that deals a pathetic 18 base damage, and it doesn't get any bonus for critical hits. The second you find another gun, you're going to gently set this one down and forget that you ever used it. And that, well, that's a perfect way to start today's list. Next up is the pistol in GTA Online. Now, GTA Online is all about doing missions, getting that money, securing the bag, and buying better and better gear along the way. But how many of you have bad memories of trying to find your footing with the starting pistol? Sure, some of us had friends willing to give us guns to make sure we had a decent start, but then there were the others. The ones who had to do the first couple GTA Online missions using the crappy starting pistol and then whatever they could scrape up off the ground. On its own, the pistol isn't horrible, but when you're trying to do a mission with it, well, it's absolutely terrible. Next up is the BB gun in Fallout 3. Now, Fallout 3 is a series all about exploration. Find the right weapons for your playstyle, but you know what gun doesn't fit anybody's playstyle? The BB gun. BB. This is one of the first guns you get your hands on in Fallout 3, and in terms of stats, it's like a real BB gun. Now, granted, it's supposed to be your tutorial gun. It's not supposed to do much damage, but if you actually take this thing with you into combat beyond the first hour or so of the game, well, you are going to get what's coming, and you deserve it. It deals a pathetic 3 damage, but don't worry, because if you get that critical hit, it will deal 4 damage. Yeah, the BB gun stinks, and once you're done with the tutorial, you shouldn't gently set this one down. You should chunk this one as far away from you as you possibly can. Now, let's move over to Warzone. The X-16. Now, I love that Warzone spawned you in with a gun, I do. And, I mean, yeah, but does it have to be something as bad as this? When you drop into a match of Warzone Battle Royale, you'll have the X-16 handgun and a couple spare mags in your pocket. This means, if you get screwed by weapon spawns, you can at least fight back. However, most people will just run around and hit people with the gun instead of shooting the gun at the person, because frankly, that may be a better strategy. It's terrible. The fire rate cap is low, the visual kick is very high, and the damage is pitiful. Now look, I know it's not supposed to be an amazing gun or anything, but why is it this bad? And why is punching people ever better than shooting somebody, right? Isn't that a little backwards? At this point, why don't they just spawn us in with a hammer or maybe a boxing glove and let us go at it? The X-16, it sucks. There's just no other way around it. You know another pistol that sucks? The Makarov in Black Ops 1. Speaking of terrible Call of Duty pistols, how about arguably the worst one? Worst one in COD history. The Makarov was your starting handgun in the original Black Ops, and despite sharing an aim with a Modern Warfare villain that was awesome, this Makarov wasn't killing anybody. Standard handgun, 8 rounds in the mag, but extremely low damage, very awkward handling, and a low fire rate cap. And did I mention that the iron sights on the gun, well, they're weird, they're off. A lot of you probably forgot what the Makarov even was. Sure, you remember there was a gun called the Makarov, but how many of you actually remember what it looked like or how it functioned? I'm gonna bet none of you. The gun was trash, and it's definitely one of the worst starting guns in gaming history. Now let's fast forward to a current game. The classic in Valorant. A tactical shooter, 2 teams, go off, 5 each, or 5v5, face off against each other, try to destroy or defend a point of interest. Sound familiar? Then, in between rounds, you can use currency to buy better gear and guns. Familiar as well. Sounds like Counter-Strike. It's because it is. But there's one thing Valorant has that CS doesn't. It's the Classic. The Classic is a standard handgun that everybody spawns in with that you can buy for free. I don't know if that works. You can't really say you buy it if it's free, right? As you probably imagine, it's no good. Now, it can deal up to 78 damage to the head, but it's horribly inaccurate, and if you're hitting the chest or limbs, you might as well be spitting on your target because they're just going to walk it off. I know the starting weapon in a game, like Valorant, isn't supposed to be amazing, but the Classic, it's kind of a headache to use. If it was a little more accurate, maybe it wouldn't be quite as bad, but yeah, It's on today's video, so it's pretty bad. You know another one that's pretty bad? The P2020 in Apex Legends. I know it's not technically a level one gun because Apex is Battle Royale, but it's going to get a spot on the list because of how common it is and how completely useless it is. Standard handgun seems to always be all over the floor. No matter where you drop, you can get a P2020. In terms of damage, it's bad. Usually hits for around 10, which makes it weaker than running up and punching somebody. Now, it does have a nice hop-up attachment that will increase the damage to around 36, but you're not guaranteed to get it. You'll often just get stuck with the default P2020, which is hands down the worst gun in the game. Yes, you heard me right. I would rather have a Mozambique than a P2020. The Mozambique may be terrible in the meme of the century, but at least it doesn't eat up my ammo in the process. Now let's jump over to Spartanville. Well, Halo. Halo Combat Evolved, to be specific. The assault rifle. I know, I said it, don't kill me. Despite the CE assault rifle shooting really fast and having a giant magazine, most anyone will tell you it's kind of crap. I mean, in both campaign and multiplayer. Now, in campaign, the assault rifle is only good for mowing down grunts, but on the higher difficulties, it's not even very good at that. Then, the multiplayer, the CE assault rifle is terrible. There's a reason why in CE multiplayer, everybody switches to their pistol when they spawn in. What other game can you think of with a starting pistol works dramatically better than the starting assault rifle? Again, the CE assault rifle has a giant magazine and a really high fire rate, but it's useless in most parts of the campaign. It's always useless in multiplayer, so I think it's more than deserving of the number three spot. Now we've arrived at number two. The pistol in Doom 2016. This is a great game full of absolutely awesome guns, but there is one gun that nobody used. The pistol. It's the first gun put in your hands, and it's the only weapon for the first 60 seconds of the campaign. At that point, you're given the combat shotgun, and from then on, you only switch to the pistol if you're completely out of ammo for everything else. You would almost rather have Doom Guy throw rocks. It's just bad. And I know that's the point, but they could have at least given you a way to improve it. Sure, it does have a charge shot that you can upgrade, but how often are you actually going to use that? And on the higher difficulty settings, that charge shot isn't even a one-shot kill on every enemy. The Doom 2016 pistol is hot garbage, and there's a reason why Doom Eternal just straight up deleted it. And at number one today, we're going to stick with Doom, the Doom pistol in Doom 3. Yep, arguably the worst in the series. Again, I know the pistols in Doom games aren't supposed to be anything special, but the Doom 3 pistol goes beyond anything, nothing special. It's the first gun you get your hands on and quickly becomes useless. I know it's accurate, it sounds pretty beefy, but it also does no damage. It hits for 14 per shot, and it's only effective on big, slow enemies, and even then, you should only be using it when you need to conserve ammo for other weapons. The Doom 3 pistol is bad, and if you ask me, it's the worst starting gun in any game ever. I mean, is that too harsh? I'll let you guys be the judge. I don't know. Let me know one pistol that was worse. Not a pistol, just one level one gun that was worse that didn't make it on the list, and I'll see you guys soon.